brothers and sisters.
Kenny, I wanna Kenny, what you playing with tonight. That thing?
Back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter.
Stuck in ambition and I don't know what tomorrow holds, but I'ma jump right up in it, yeah. Geronimo, yeah, Geronimo. Boy, like my guys are controlling, I don't gotta fold. My forehead in triplets, let's just walk by faith and watch the promise come forth, because he meant it. I'm losing count of mistakes, I'm losing track of the wrongs. To come up is crazy, letting it go is a grace. I put my heart in a song and play it like David. Doesn't matter what I see no more, I'm holding on to the vision, yeah. I ain't who I used to be no more, and don't care if you see the difference.
Hey girl, hey, praise God, it is a new day. Y'all just saw me get my workout in, girl. When I say that workout was so needed, because I woke up just feeling like a little weird, just a little bit anxious. I feel like the Monday little anxieties are always a thing. So I was so glad to, one, pray, first and foremost, but then also move my able body, the body that God has blessed me with. So I feel so much better. I'm very excited for today. It is a new day. The sun is shining. Birds are chirping. The vibes are here. So welcome to a new vlog. I missed you. How have you been, girl? We are on our way back home. I need to shower, get the kids dressed. Jenna might be staying home. You already know the routine on this, okay? Daycare is just a revolving cycle of germs. So last night she wasn't feeling the greatest. So we are going to see, and hopefully she's feeling better this morning. Hopefully her fever broke, but it was literally last night when she just got a fever. So we'll scope out the scenery, see what's going on, see how she's feeling, and I will meet y'all back at the house. Okay, we are upstairs about to get the babies dressed. I feel like I can finally breathe. It's always like a race in the morning. I think I'm gonna bring them in for a half day at school just because I have some errands to run. But girl, whew, let's take a deep breath, okay? It's a new day. We're blessed, we're highly favored, and everything is okay. I always get so stressed out in the morning because I'm trying to do a million things at once, but we're just gonna calm down. And I've been getting a lot of questions about sleep routines, and because I talk about how the kids are sleeping through the night, which is so nice. And yesterday, Ezra had a really, really good sleep. He woke up at 8:30 today, y'all. It's 9:20 right now, but Javon said that he didn't wake up till 8:30. So he's been sleeping really, really well, haven't you, man? He's been a really, really good sleeper. And I always get a lot of questions about how did I sleep train my kids, you know, this, that, and the third. And I just wanna talk a little bit about the importance of sleep training. If I did not sleep train my kids, y'all, I would have like, what happened to your toe? I'm a routine girl, right? And if I don't have a routine, things are just gonna be chaotic for me. So sleep training was just non-negotiable. And a huge tool that I used to sleep train was actually the Huckleberry app. And Huckleberry is actually sponsoring this vlog. Thank you so much, Huckleberry. Huckleberry is an app that helps you track all of your baby's activity from sleep to meals, bottles, diaper changes, medicine, and they even have a potty training feature, which we're gonna start using with the Genesis. What I love about Huckleberry is that it fits so seamlessly into my everyday routine. When I give Ezra a bottle or I put him down for his nap, I just make sure to log that in the Huckleberry app. And then what's dope is the more you use it, the more it gets to know your baby. Specifically, I love the sweet spot feature that is part of their Premium Plus membership. It basically predicts when your baby is going to be tired, so that way you don't have to do the mental math, because I don't know if y'all like me, but I am always planning like a million steps ahead. If I know Ezra has to sleep at 3, that means I have to start this thing at 1, and that means that I can't have this thing conflicting at 1:30 because he has to get his bottle at 2. It's just a whole entire just thing that happens in my head. I love that with the sweet spot feature, it takes all that mental load and puts it right into an app and will actually send me notifications when Ezra's naps are coming up. So the sweet spot feature has been amazing for sleep training and getting both of my kids on a very consistent sleep schedule. So whether you are trying to track your baby's day-to-day activities or get them on a more consistent sleep schedule, make sure to download Huckleberry today, and new users will actually get 2 weeks of free access to sweet spot. It's hot, it's hot, it is very hot.
Hey, what are y'all wearing to school?
I'm just gonna bring them in for a couple of hours so I can go ahead and do my running around. Jenna is actually gonna end up needing some more fall clothes. She has a lot of clothes, but they're like the 18 month and she's taller. They're just not working out for her. So we are going to be doing our run to Walmart. You guys already know, getting her some clothes, and then we'll do a closet refresh and everything like that. So it's just gonna be easier if the kids are at school. Okay, I need y'all, because look, y'all, they be fighting, and this is the problem. Y'all need to love one another. What does Jesus say? To love your neighbor as you love yourself. So that means don't be doing nothing to him that you want to do to yourself. Let's see. Probably put Ezra in these little jogger pants. Jenna already has a sweatsuit on. Do you want to show him? Cute. That's cute. You like the heart? But what we need to do is brush your teeth because it's very questionable. Your breath is hot.
No.
Look, she always gets so embarrassed when I tell her that. It is though. What are we gonna do with your hair? As far as a top, probably leaning towards this blue one since his pants are blue. Hopefully they're the same shade. What are y'all doing? Cause I just hear ruckus. Ruckus, ruckus, ruckus.
Mommy, I bounced.
You bounced? Okay, well why is the why is the giraffe on the floor?
Come on, Ezra. Mommy, I bounce.
Okay, go bounce.
Ready, set.
Ready, set, go. Go again. Ready, set, go. Good job. Kids, bro. One more time. Ready, set, go, go, go. You stuck? Okay. Sweet man. Isn't Ezra such a sweet man?
No.
Yes, he is. Dude! Stop! Stop! You think it's funny? I gotta strap you down. All right, today's gonna be a good day. No, I know you're not about to jump on his head, so move. What did I just say, Genesis? You need to be careful. Yeah, you did that. Why? No, it's not funny. Nobody's laughing. Okay, let's brush your teeth, because that's first priority for sure. Brush teeth, wash face, do your hair. Come see mom. What's the vibe of the day? Are we grateful? Are we joyful? Are we all of the above? Jenna, say cheese. No, 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 no. Let me do it first, and then you can do it. Open up. Cheese. You gotta say cheese, so I can get back. Gotta get them back teeth. You want no cavities. So almost all of her teeth are in. She just has a couple, her molars haven't come in the back. But other than that, sis is looking good. You don't want to walk in there, people looking at you funny and stuff.
I want this one.
And you got to put lotion on too.
I want this one, Mama.
Now I understand why every morning my mom had a rag that she was so aggressively rubbing against our face with some lotion to follow. And it's like, I wish my babies would. Is my hair in the back coming out? It's like, I wish my babies would be out here. Switch. Little man got four teeth. Ah, y'all see his little teeth? They're so cute. Okay, come on. I know nobody likes it. Nobody likes it, but it's necessary. Nobody likes it. Rag and lotion are non-negotiable. Cute, my man. Hygiene is done. Next up, we gotta do hair. My man, you look like me right now. Look, look, my man. He does. He does. Y'all can't play me. Y'all can't. Okay, if you guys are looking for a real Christian Rachel, we were watching Miss Jackie, but Miss Letty, she really gives the Miss Rachel vibe. All about Jesus. All about the Lord. So I love Miss Letty. Jenna loves Miss Letty. She's been over here talking about, I love Jesus.
Jesus. I love Jesus.
So I'm like, fill these children with the Lord. If we're gonna be memorizing songs, kids are sponges. They will soak up whatever they listen to. They will soak up whatever is around them. And even like Jenna, she literally copies everything we do. I forget what Javon was doing yesterday. Yeah, he was grilling and he like was looking at the fire. He took a couple steps in and like looked at the fire. And then Jenna took a couple steps in and looked at the fire. Then Javon put his hands on his hips. Then Jenna put his hands on her hips. So it's like, they're always watching. So they're gonna do what you do, not what you say. Okay, let me get me a man. Oh,
sweet, sweet, sweet.
Hi, buddy.
Hey.
Girl, kids are at school. I really need to clock in for like an hour and knock out some work stuff, but I also, like I said, want to do some running around. I want to see if I can get in for a nail appointment today because I also need to get these eyebrows done. These eyebrows look crazy. So I'm going to see if my nail lady can fit me in at 12. And then, of course, we have to go pick up Jenna some new clothes. And then I have a couple of skincare items that I do have to pick up as well. When I woke up, I was just in like, I had a little bit of anxiety, but then I prayed, and this is the best way I could explain it, because I'm still trying to get out of the habit of like shame and condemnation and meditating on like my past and who I used to be before Christ. And I guess the analogy that came to mind when I was thinking about it, have you ever been so excited to give somebody a gift? Like you spent so much time, so much money getting this little gift together and you were so excited. And then you give the gift to them and they're like, oh my gosh, this is too much. Like, please, I cannot accept this gift. It's too much. It costs too much. It took too much time. Like, I can't accept this. And then you're mad because you're like, listen, I just spent all of my resources on this gift. I want you to happily accept this gift. I feel like really that's how God is with us sometimes. Like the sacrifice that Jesus Christ made on Mount Calvary for us, dying on the cross and rising again for our sins. Like that was such a huge gift so that we could be gifted with salvation. And then we just be like, no, it's too much. Like I've done too much. My sin is too heavy. I can't accept the gift. And looking at it from that perspective, it's just like, we need to accept the gift. I need to accept the gift. I need to accept the gift of salvation and accept the gift of forgiveness that comes with salvation, that Jesus has literally forgiven every single one of my sins and that I am a new person, a new creation in Christ Jesus. That is so exciting. That is really good news. And sometimes we just meditate so much on our past or our faults or where we fall short that we forget the good news that we are literally made new in Christ. Not made perfect, but made new. And that's kind of just what got me out of my little rut this morning. I was just like, God, you have forgiven me, so I can forgive me. And you want me to forgive myself. Like you have given me this gift with such joy that you want me to forgive myself. And I don't want to hold on to it. I don't want to hold on to unforgiveness for myself because that's doing the gift that cost you so much. It's doing an injustice. So I don't know, girl. You need to start forgiving yourself for something. I know that we all hang on to like certain faults and sins of our own. And it's just like, you need to let that go because God let it go. And if you have repented, meaning turning from your ways, your sins have been forgiven. So that's how I was feeling this morning. And it feels good just to walk in freedom, the freedom of Christ Jesus. It feels really good. So I'm going to head home, probably knock out an hour of work. And then we're going to head back out. I'm going to see if I can hop in to get my nails done because definitely need to do that today. And hopefully we'll be able to still make this little 2 o'clock appointment. Girl, I have this little 2 o'clock appointment for a Pilates thing. I don't know if it's gonna work out for me, but time will tell.
Office mode. I've literally already changed 4 times today. Clearly I have different roles. Y'all, I'm tired. It just hit me like in one wave. Your girl just went from super energized to very tired. So I'm hoping that this little coffee right here is gonna do the trick because that creamer is good. So I ended up switching to a almond milk creamer, which I should have been because of all my stomach issues, but it's the Chobani cookie dough and it is actually so good. Like really good. Oh my goodness. Then last night I ended up making Caesar salad. This was my meal because Javon is on a fast. So I'm like, okay, while you're fasting, I'm gonna be eating healthy because Javon low-key be trying to fry food and he's the culprit of my big bag activities. So while he's on a fast, I'm gonna be eating healthy. No, I'm definitely a willing participant in the big bag activities, but like sometimes he'd be doing the most. Like, can I just have a salad for dinner? Like a meal, this would not be a meal for Javon. He would be like, what is this? This is an appetizer. So I had some homemade Caesar dressing. That was so good, y'all. I am not a store-bought ranch, store-bought, I could be a store-bought blue cheese, but I'm not a store-bought Caesar. So I'm learning how to make all of my dressings and they taste so much better, y'all. It's extra, okay? Taking those extra steps and doing the little things. But I promise you, your dressing is gonna taste so much better. It's gonna taste like restaurant quality. And at that point, girl, it just feels like you're at a restaurant, but you made it at home. And then I did some blackened shrimp as well with some croutons. So I love salads because you can get like a lot on your plate, but the lettuce is filling, but it's not calorie dense. So it's a nice little hack if you're super hungry and you feel like you wanna eat a lot of food. Just make a big old salad. I have so much work to do. I like to make my office feel like a coffee shop.
So I always throw on some little jazz music, just get the vibes going, open the curtains, get the bright sun. I'm gonna open up the windows as well because it's nice and cool out, and just hopefully wake up, girl, because your girl is so sleepy right now. I did text my nail lady. I'm waiting on her to respond. Hopefully I can get in with her today. Also need a call to book a hair appointment because we are definitely transitioning out of these. I want to get something similar but just a lighter color. So need to do that as well. But then I also have so much work to do. Let me stop yapping. Let's just knock out like 2 hours of work so that way we can go out running the errands and then get the kids ready. It is time to run and get my nails done. Look at this cute bag my best friend got me for my birthday, y'all. So cute. The perfect little just in your time of need. In your time of need, you just gotta hold it together. But I'm gonna switch some stuff from this bag. This is like my main bag, y'all know. I got this for my birthday too. So I can pop in my keys. This is my favorite hand cream. Not only is it moisturizing, but also smells so good. And I get so many compliments on how I smell from that. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop that in. I need me an array of fragrances and lotions. So I'm gonna put my Forever Mood. That's always my little travel. I'm a little travel girl. Then I got my Wonder Skin. She's my gloss. My moisturizing is my Laneige. And then the only thing that isn't the best about this little purse is you can't fit like a full-size wallet in here. So you'll just need to take your cards out, but I don't really care as long as I remember to put my cards back in when I'm done. So pop in my card, and then I think that's it. Got my Bibles in this one. Always keep some gum on me. I think so, darling. A little hair tie. This is just so cute. It's just like the little cutest little bag, y'all. I might have overstuffed her though. Take out my gum. Just add a piece in there. One piece. She's cute, she's classy, she's very demure. Little tuck. I'm over here playing like I got time. I need to be at my nail appointment now, so let's go. This is coming from a Madison Ryan Ward curl. Is anybody else just a teeny tiny, just a little bit underwhelmed by her new album? I'm just a little bit underwhelmed, and I have literally been listening to it every day. I'm like, okay, today's the day where it's just going to hit. I don't know. I feel like her past two albums were so good. I just feel like there's not a song in the album that's really like standing out to me. Every song kind of just sounds the same. Madison, I love you, bro. I promise you I do. It's constructive criticism. I don't know. Amen came out and it was just like, oh my gosh, like she's coming out with this album is about to be it. Like Amen was just such a banger. I feel like this music, like her new album, kind of gives me like office music chill vibes. Like it's not something like I want to listen to and like I'm excited, like I'm like, yeah, I'm kind of just like typing away at a computer. That's my take on it. Am I gonna listen to it? Yes, absolutely. I will say Honeycomb is good. I like Honeycomb. That's probably my favorite song on the album. But yeah, I don't know, that's just kind of how I'm feeling about it. I am not being a hater, I promise you. Like, I love my good sis. Love my good sis down. Love her down. But as a loyal, dedicated fan, I also have to just speak my truth. And I don't know, I thought there was gonna be a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Love her regardless. Gonna listen to it regardless. Just definitely looking forward to the next album, seeing what other creativity she's gonna bring to the scene, because my good sis don't play. And I'm also very mad that her Atlanta live concert sold out so fast. Like I literally went to look, I think it was like 7 days after it went live, sold out, gone, done. I was like, oh well, at least I'm going to Axe 242 in the next couple weeks. I think it's like 2 weeks away. My good friend is coming with me, so it's gonna be a really, really good time. I cannot wait for the Axe 242 conference. You already know, and if you don't know, baby, it's sold out. So should have got it while you could. No, that conference is gonna be so amazing, and just it's a discipleship conference with Jackie Hill Perry, Megan Ashley, with guest appearances from obviously Preston's gonna be there, Pastor Philip Michaels. There's some other good ones, but yeah, it's gonna be a really good conference. I'm excited, but I need to hurry up, get in there, because my appointment is right now, and I don't like being late. Thought that I was dreaming when you said you love me. Started nothing, I had no chance to prepare, couldn't see you coming. are square. Listen, I'm tired for fighting for my life, okay? Like, the almond is cute. It is so cute. It's so cutesy, but it's not functional. And my nails were starting to get very, very long to the point where it was just like, girl, what are you doing? Like, cut your nails. Because you guys know I got a new iPad for my birthday. So I just ordered like a little keyboard, a little Bluetooth keyboard. And I'm trying to give the girls click, 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 click. And I can't do that if I had almond nails. I also got like a special raised keyboard though. So the raised keyboards, like, you can still type with your finger. What is this called? Pad of your finger instead of your tip. I still am not going to be able to type with my tip because my nails aren't super short, but like, at least I'll be able to type on the raised keyboard with ease. So I am excited for that, and hopefully that'll come in tonight. Let me tell you the plan of what's supposed to happen. Me and Javon are supposed to go to this little trial class because I want to try out this Pilates studio and he wants to try out the stretch class that they have there. That's supposed to be in 30 minutes. I really need to call this man and see what's going on, because I guarantee he's not dressed. I mean, I'm not dressed, so I can't say much, but let me just see, girl, because I'm trying to be giving the girls Pilates. And let me tell you why. I will get in the gym, I will lift some weights, but when it comes to cardio, that's where I struggle with. And if you're really trying to lose those pounds, lose those inches, you need cardio. And then Pilates is just a good toning regimen. I have a treadmill now, and I'm going to show you guys it in a little bit later, but I have a treadmill now that I'm trying to walk on for at least an hour a day. I'm going to still do my weight training at least 3 times a week, and then I want to implement 2 days of Pilates a week to really help tone and firm. Tone and firm. Those are the words of Q4. Tone and firm. And drop them inches. Okay? Because I just need all the cardio in my life. And I tried out a Pilates class last week and I really liked it. Like, I really, really liked it. So I just want to see what the studio near me is like. So let's see what Javon's got going on. Because if he is wanting to go, I need to hurry up. I mean, we kind of have to go. I already told the lady we were going. Hey, it's 1:30.
Are you here?
I'm about to be there in like 4 minutes.
Are you dressed already?
No, but I'm gonna throw something on real quick.
I already checked in. Did you check in?
Check in.
It's in the app. You gotta check in.
App? I don't got no app. All right, well, I don't know about no app, but I'm gonna definitely be there.
All right.
Y'all always want to app, book, pre-register, pre-signed paperwork, like, what happened to signing when I get there, girl? I'm already fighting for my life to get there. I'm already struggling to get to the class on time. But if this all works out for me, I'm really about to be a Pilates mommy. Like, for real. I feel like Pilates, at least for my body type, I know that I need to continue to lift weights. Like, that just is what it is, because I do lose a lot of weight just by lifting. But I know I can maximize my results if I just really start implementing cardio and like higher intensity workouts. Because sometimes I'll lift weights and not really sweat because I'm building the muscle, yes, but like, I need to also shed the fat. I need to also shed the fat, because you can be building all the muscle, but all the fat on top is not even showing the muscle, and that's not what I need in my life. What I need is to be lean cuisine. So I think Pilates is really gonna help me with that, especially because it just triggers certain muscles that you didn't even know were there if you're really engaging. Now, you can go through a whole Pilates workout and not feel anything because you're not engaging and you're not having that mind muscle connection. But if you really hone in and like connect and engage and brace the core in every single movement, you are going to be sore. I had a trial class a week ago, and literally the next morning my abs woke up sore. My abs have never been sore, okay? And I've been lifting weights for how many years now? So that's what I'm excited about, just trying something new, switching it up. Like, sometimes when your workout routine feels a little bit stagnant, you just have to find new things. Like, maybe it's walking, maybe you try running for a little bit, maybe you try a solid core class, maybe you try Pilates, maybe you try just working out by yourself at the gym. Like, just switch it up, because if this is a lifestyle thing, which it is, then obviously there's gonna be seasons where it feels a little bit redundant, and that's when you gotta sprinkle a little bit of razzle dazzle. My sunroof is not open. It's very, very dark in here. So I'm excited for that. We're gonna see what's going on with all of the things. I need to throw something on. We're gonna go try out this class, go get the kids, go to Walmart, get some clothes, go back home, play with the kids, do the dinner thing, do the mom thing. Like, I'm at it. I'm here. I'm ready. I'm fired up. I was feeling a little bit tired, but I have no option. There's no nap available. There's no nap window today. There's no nap in the book. So we need to just get it together. It's going to be a really, really good day. Nails are done. Eyebrows got cleaned up. I didn't show y'all, but yeah, she cleaned up my eyebrows. They look real, real nice. Thank you so much, Amy. So let me grab Javon. We're going to try this Pilates studio out. Back.
a bit.
I don't think Javon was really in the know about Pilates, so he was very confused about the socks.
I just don't understand. Why can't they just make grippy socks without the big old
I mean, they do, the but I like the open Pilates.
So you bought those?
No, I absolutely did. Hopefully this works out for us.
At least I'm here with my wife, so they know I'm not, you know, on the fruitier side of things.
He just be going to Google for things, and Google told him Pilates was created by some military.
It was. I definitely looked at Google.
But he didn't know everybody. Pilates was for the girls.
But it was created by a Marine.
Review.
I actually enjoyed it, and to be honest, like, I am not embarrassed by that either. Like, I'm in Pilates, okay. I'm doing it with my wife.
No!
I asked them, they said the other dudes do it too, and also too, it's mad NBA players and stuff that be doing like
it's like
stuff
because
it helps with certain. I guarantee you, LeBron does Pilates. I told you at 34.
Cause Javon's birthday's tomorrow. I forgot to tell y'all his birthday's tomorrow.
Yeah, at 34, I am prioritizing flexibility.
Yeah.
Mobility.
Right.
Cardio.
Because you've been lifting weights for so long, and your back and stuff is jacked.
Yeah, my sciatica.
Like it's not helping. What you need is stretching.
Yeah.
Mobility and then intentional movements. Like it's not always about can you squat 300 pounds?
Right.
Like it's like okay, but can you
move? Can you get up?
Can you get up? Groceries?
Right. Can you carry your kids on your back? Like it's some important stuff out there that I'm prioritizing at this era of my life. So.
But no, the class was good. So we signed up for a membership. So we're gonna do it 2 times a week, and they have a whole bunch of different classes. So we're gonna be doing cardio sculpt on Wednesday, which is a cardio class, and then I also want to get in another Pilates class by the end of the week. Okay, because I'm using all my credits.
I'm definitely gonna use mine. That'll force me to use them too.
Right? Exactly.
Actually, this works out perfect because I can break up my LA Fitness too, and it kind of gives me more like inspiration. Like I'm still gonna get my weights in.
Right.
But now I don't need to do my weights 5 days a week.
Right, and that's what I was saying. Like I'm still gonna train, very much train 3 days a week, and now having Pilates 2 days a week, that brings me to the 5, which I wanted to be at, on top of walking for an hour a day. Like it's really giving winter arc.
Why do trucks drive so aggressive on the road? Like they got just this energy about them where they like intentionally want to drive you off the road, or they speed up, they don't want nobody around them, they just think that their truck gives them like superpowers, bruh. Like that stuff is annoying. But
Shout out. Jesus is Lord. Okay, Javon said that's how you about to start answering the phone. Hello, Jesus is Lord.
Because they need
Can
to know.
Can you still make voice, what's it called?
They need to know. Like you reached Maya.
Right.
Yeah.
Can you reach Maya?
Yeah, you can.
Jesus is Lord. I'm about to do that. This is literally like my favorite lunch spot. I kind of feel bad, y'all. Javon's on a fast. And he's just supporting us. Jenna, you gotta eat some of that first. Have a piece of chicken, then you can have the cookie. Eat it. Then you can't have it. That's why you gotta hide stuff, folks. So we're gonna run to Walmart after this, and we're gonna get you some clothes, girl.
Man.
I have been everywhere today, literally everywhere. We ended up going to Walmart, 3 bags of clothing later, and got Jenna all restocked on some new clothes for winter and fall. So I really thought that she was gonna be able to use most of her clothes from last year, which were like 24 months, but she's in a 3T now. So I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all some of the things we got her. I just love little cute, like, okay. All right, Jenna is not gonna be letting us have a haul here, but just little two pieces for her to throw on, especially for school. Like, simple. You guys know I am an advocate for dress them kids like they are kids. So that's exactly what I do for my babies. Just cute little little girl. She doesn't feel good, which is why I'm letting her have her little binky, because she needs a comfort in this moment. She was okay, and now she's kind of going backwards. It's okay, baby. Another little church outfit, just this little cute two-piece. She had a couple of these last winter, so I just got them in a 3T, which is so cute. But these are my favorite, like the little $3 just t-shirts that you can pair with the leggings, and they always match, like the little hearts on here match these leggings, and these are flared, which I thought was adorable. Oh, this is another cute little church dress. I think this one was like $7. So I could just throw this on with some tights, as well as this yellow one. These are definitely more fall. They're a bit lighter, so we can throw a little jean jacket over those for you, Jenna. Ooh. Cutesy with the green. These are like her go-to for school. She's always gonna have some type of little matching set. Love this one. It's with princesses or fairies on it. And then I did go ahead and grab her these for church. Just the perfect little throw me under for any dresses she has, as well as some socks. Grab Ezra some grippy socks as well, because dude is trying to walk. And okay, I think that's all Jenna's stuff. So for Ezra, I can't just buy one kid's stuff and not the other, so I found him some pajamas, and then just some little throw me ons. Y'all know, cute little acorn, like my little man with his little cargos. He's in an 18 months, y'all, can y'all believe it? Just a little thicker sweatsuit. And then I'm also glad that I did grab him these, because he doesn't have any 18 month just regular onesies. These I'll throw under the little sweatsuit, so that way he's layered up. Oh my gosh, I thought this one was so cute. So they're striped bottoms, right? Like, adorable. And then, cause he looks like a little bear to me. So I was like, Ezra, we have to get this for you, cause you look like a little bear. This is what Ezra looks like to me. So got him that, then I found a little panda one. So I was like, okay, great. This is gonna be perfect for daycare. Just throw that on. I like am almost convinced he literally has this one, but also the last time I bought him clothes, I bought them in 12 months and he is a 18 month now. So grab that one. And then just one last little throw me on jump. And it's just some little dinosaurs on a skateboard. Why are they skateboarding? I don't know. Okay, I also want to give a little quick shout out to Chance of Sunny, because they sent the babies a PR package, but this lotion smells so good. And when I say my babies be knocked out, like sometimes kids' lavender lotion, it doesn't really smell like lavender. I can tell there is lavender essential oil all up in this thing. I'm gonna go ahead and clear out all of her 18 months. Like, y'all, I'm telling you, every one of her leggings, I swore, I'm like, oh yeah, these are gonna fit. Even the 24. These are not going to fit her long legs. Now y'all know, if we're in the store, Javon's gonna find the kids something. This dude got a basketball.
I've been asking for this. I mean, he's been asking for this for a long time.
Like, which was it? Who's asking?
Yeah.
He got them a little basketball hoop, and while he's doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and go through her stuff. Like, even the 24s are gonna fit. So sad. The 18s.
You wanna play too?
Done with the 18s. So I'm gonna pass these along to my niece, aka my goddaughter. I'm so glad that I'm able to at least give them to her, because I would have been heartbroken, like, having to donate all of Jenna's clothes.
Look, he's ready. Man, is that a football? Is that Ohio State starting running back? Are you Ohio State starting quarterback? Are you going to the league? Are you going to the league, my man? Jenna, are you going to play in the Olympics?
Yeah.
You going to play in the Olympics? Kick the ball. Yay, my kids. We're going to be at all the games.
I'm over here sorting, organizing. These are give to baby Gia summer clothes, donate to the church. So hopefully I'll get all this done tonight.
Girl, two workouts in one day has me done for. I'm just gonna wash all these clothes now. If I don't do it now, I'm gonna forget, and I want her to be able to wear something, one of these tomorrow. The fact that I still have to cook dinner is a very daunting task, but I can do it. I can do all things through Christ. I really just need to finish all this, take a really nice long hot shower, read my word, and go to sleep because I'm tired. That was a lot. I did end up at least cleaning out their drawers with the clothes that no longer fit Jenna, so at least I did that. I'll do her closet another day. I just don't have the strength. And I also have to fold these. So we're about to start bath time. That'll be good. Get the kids down and to sleep.
Oh,
I totally forgot. I have like a whole hour of work after this because I have some stuff to still do. Some like admin stuff that I forgot about. Ooh, hey. The fact that I still have the clothes on, I wore to Pilates and I'm sweating. It's just a teller of what's going on. But two workouts in a day, like, who is she? Maybe while I do my hour of work, I'll walk on the treadmill. I don't know how well that's gonna go because I have to type, but maybe I'm able to finesse it. We shall see. Skincare, and I'm about to go to sleep. I'm not gonna work. I'm not gonna do that because I've literally done all I possibly can today, and whatever hasn't gotten done will get done tomorrow. Because if I try to just overextend myself, one, I'm not going to be working at my maximum like effort. I just refuse to half do things when I can just do them in the morning. Yes, they're gonna be 12 hours late, but I'd rather them be 12 hours late and amazing than on time and not up to my standards. So shout out to the moms, because I know we be all over the place and still feel like we have not done enough, and that's a really hard feeling. But girl, I'm proud of you. Whatever you've done today, you may have just changed diapers all day, I am proud of you. You're amazing. You are doing all that you possibly can, and anything that hasn't gotten done today, it's okay. We're gonna do it in the morning, and I don't want you to feel bad about it. I don't want you to feel condemned and shameful about it. Like, you literally did everything you could, girl. We're here. We're here. And like I said, I'm about to go rub my feet together, read my word, and go to sleep. So I hope you enjoyed this little day in my life. I always love spending time with you guys, and you guys always just, y'all mean so much to me. Like, y'all are really my, you already know what it is, you already know. But thank you so much for tuning in, girl. I will definitely be seeing you guys in the next video, and I hope you have a blessed week. Bye.